So how do you measure the coastline of a country? Let's draw a little bit of coastline here. Make it nice and... So imagine this is somewhere in the north of Scotland or something like that.
Which side's the sea?
This is the sea here.
Okay.
All right. You could use a really big ruler and just kind of line it up and go around and see how much we've got. So I'm going to use a ruler that's about this long. There's one lot of ruler there. There's two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So this coastline is 9 units long, 9 of those rulers long. But I'm not getting into all the nooks and crannies and the lumps and bumps and stuff like that. So let's use a smaller ruler. Let's use a ruler that is half the size. So I'm just gonna do that just by eye, trying to work out. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I did it by eye, but I was trying to make the brown rulers half the size of the orange rulers. So 2 9s are 18. We've ended up with 4 extra short rulers. So by measuring with a shorter ruler, we've got a longer length of coastline. This is always the case. So the smaller I make the ruler, the bigger the answer. I'm getting into more of the little nooks and crannies. That's the important thing. So the more kind of lumps and bumps you get into, the bigger the answer you get. So the question then becomes, how small does our ruler need to be? So let's have a look at a few examples of different scales. Let's zoom in on a little bit of this coastline here. So as if we're flying along in a plane. And so this bit of coastline might look like that as we zoom in. Let's zoom in even further. So we're looking at a craggy sort of rock edge. What might that look like? And that craggy rock edge might look something like that. So we want to zoom in even further, maybe a little rock that's jutting out from that edge. So we're crouching down, we're eyeballing a bit of rock, and maybe that bit of rock looks something like that. We get our microscope out and we have a look even closer at the sort of fine grained detail of the rock, and maybe it looks something like that. Problem is, it's lumpy and bumpy all the way down. There's no obvious point where we say, okay, this is the size of our ruler. So we need a ruler that kind of got into all the sort of molecular lumps and bumps to get a true answer. But is that a true answer? It would be a meaningless answer. It would be, you know, hundreds, thousands, millions of times greater than what we got at this scale, depending on how low you go down. Suddenly, we're measuring the coastline of Britain, say, to be millions of kilometers, and that doesn't feel like a useful answer. So we present it to some mathematicians to see what they think. And so let's have a look then at a sort of mathematically perfect coastline. Isn't that beautiful? Brady, I know you like to know where the sea is, so here's the sea. But our mathematical coastline needs to mirror the real world coastline, so it needs to be lumpy and bumpy. So let's put a little lump in like that. So now we've got a lumpy, bumpy coastline. But we need to be able to zoom in and for it to continue to be lumpy in the same way that the real coastline is. So now each of these straight lines, let's put a little bump in all of these as well. But again, we need to be able to zoom in and for it to still be lumpy and bumpy. So now every straight line that we've just created needs to have a lumpy bit in it as well. This is the last one I'll draw. Okay, so to be like a coastline of Britain, we need to keep doing this, keep adding lumps and bumps all the way down forever, or at least, you know, to some high degree. So how do we measure the coastline of this mathematical drawing, or how do we measure the length of this? Okay, so we can notice that this small section here is the same as the whole thing, but shrunk down. So if you take that whole thing and shrink it down, That's what you get. This section here is a third of the whole thing. So the whole, in other words, the whole thing is 3 times bigger than this one section. But let's look at it another way. This bit here is the same as this bit, and this bit, and this bit. So, we've actually got 1, 2, 3, 4. So this, the whole thing is 3 times bigger than that section, and it's 4 times bigger. So how can it be that the whole thing is 3 times bigger and 4 times bigger? Is there a number that you can multiply by 3 and 4 and get the same answer? Well, there's 0. So 0 times 3 is 0, 0 times 4 is 0. So the coastline is 0 meters long. That doesn't work, because we can see it. The other option is, it's not really a number, but it's infinity, it's infinite. So, you know, 3 times infinite is infinite, 4 times infinite is infinite. So the conclusion is that in this mathematical case, at least, so long as those lumps and bumps carry on forever, it's infinitely long. And that's, in a sense, true for the coastline of Britain. The coastline of Britain isn't infinitely long because you get down to the molecular level, but to all intents and purposes, it has no length. It's not something we can give a number to in any meaningful way. The guy that did this, well, this is called a Koch snowflake, but the guy that came up with all this stuff is Benoit B. Mandelbrot. The B stands for Benoit B. Mandelbrot, by the way. He invented this thing called fractal maths. And so, although we're left in this position where, okay, we can't measure the coastline of Britain, we now have some mathematical tools for describing it. So we can talk about the lumpiness of Britain, so, or the fractalness of Britain, and it's, I forget what it is now, it's like 0.2 lumpy, or whatever. There's some way now we have of describing the fractal nature of our own coastline and any coastline. So yeah, that is how trying to measure the coastline of a country leads to some really interesting mathematics.
You didn't tell me how we can do it though. Oh, the answer is we can't do it.
The answer is you can't do it. Sorry about that. I mean, okay, well, look it up. I mean, the thing is, if you look it up, you will find either several different answers, or you'll find someone saying, okay, you know, we're going to agree that we use a ruler that's a meter long or something like that.
You know? Right, and so you pick your resolution.
You pick your resolution, you get a number, but it's kind of meaningless because you pick a different resolution, you get a different number, you know.
You must be really fun to walk around the beach with.
I mean, the other thing, if you're measuring just the length of a beach, for example, you could arguably measure the straight line distance between one end of the beach and the other. You're not really getting the full length of the beach, but you're getting some measure that's at least useful. In the same way, you know, you could say, okay, I'm going to say the coastline of Britain is the distance from Land's End to John O'Groats doubled. Because it's far too low, the actual coastline's much longer than that. You know, or is it? There's no answer.